All right, here's another story for kindergarten, first and second grade. This one's about the prophet Elisha, and this one is called A Room and a Boy. The woman of Shunem stood on the doorstep of her flat roof mud brick home. She shaded her eyes with her hand and looked down the dusty road that led by her door. Prophet Elisha and his helper came this way, she said to her husband. The man of Shunem, who was sharpening his sickle under an olive tree, the prophet walks slowly and leans hard on his staff. I'll invite him and his helper to stop by and have bread and drink with us. Prophet Elisha thanked the woman of Shunem for the bread and the drink. When she invited him to stay and rest a while, he said, "Nay, we must hurry on. The sun is low and we have far to go." As she watched the tired men climb to the hill, she said to her husband, "Let us build a room on the roof of our house so that when the prophet comes this way, we may invite him to spend the night." Brick upon brick with mortar between, the man and the woman of Shunem built a room on the roof of their house. The bricks were made of mud and dried in the sun. Brick upon brick with mortar between, until the walls were just the right height. Then a flat roof they built over the room, and at last a stairway leading up to it. In the new room, the woman of Shunem placed a bed and a stool, a table for the prophet's Bible, and a candlestick for him to read by. Every day the woman of Shunem watched to see if Prophet Elijah and his helper were coming along the dusty path. Late one day, the prophet and his helper came by. The woman of Shunem invited them in to have bread and to stay the night. When the prophet saw the new room, he was pleased, very pleased. "What can we do to repay your kindness?" he asked. "Would you have us to speak to the king or the captain of the army for you?" "Nay, my lord," said the woman of Shunem. "My husband and I don't need any pay." But Prophet Elisha wished to do a kindness for the woman and the man of Shunem because of their kindness to him. "What could it be?" "I have noticed," said his helper, "that they have no son." When the woman of Shunem again stood at the door, Prophet Elisha said, "We shall pray God, and this time next year, he will send you and your husband a baby son." The woman of Shunem was pleased. Very pleased. And it happened just as the prophet Elisha had said. The next year, a baby boy was born to the woman and the man of Shunem. The baby's father and mother were sure that he was one of the finest and fairest babies in all the country around Shunem. And shouldn't he be? He was a prayed-for baby. As the boy grew older, he and Prophet Elisha became good friends. Now it was the boy who watched the dusty road to see if the prophet and his helper were coming. "He's coming! Prophet Elisha is coming!" he would shout and race down the road to meet him. From there to the mud brick house, the prophet had double help in walking, his staff on one side and the boy on the other. When the boy was tall enough, as tall as a bundle of barley, he begged to go to the harvest field. He couldn't cut grain with a sharp sickle, not yet, but he could pick up the grain that the reapers cut. And he did. The sun shone hot, very hot on his head. Suddenly, he dropped his armful of grain. "My head, my head," he cried. "Carry the boy to his mother," said the man of Shunem, to a young helper. All morning long, the woman of Shunem held the small boy on her lap and sponged his head with cool water. About noon, she saw that he no longer breathed. She carried him to the prophet's room and gently laid him on the prophet's bed. Then she called to her husband, "Send me a young man and your fastest mule. I wish to ride to the prophet's house." The woman of Shunem saddled the donkey with the young man, saddling another. "Ride fast," said the woman of Shunem. "Ride as fast as you can." They rode so fast that the donkeys left a swirling cloud of gray dust behind them. The woman of Shunem rode straight to the prophet's door and told him what had happened to her prayed-for boy. Prophet Elisha went home with the woman of Shunem. He climbed the stairs to his room. He opened the door, and there on the bed lay his little friend. His eyes were closed. His cheeks were pale. His hands were cold. "Dear Lord," prayed Prophet Elisha, "show me what to do to make the boy live." Prophet Elisha stretched his body over the little boy to warm him. He put his hands on the boy's hands, his cheek against the boy's cheek. He breathed into his mouth. Twice the prophet did this, and all of the time he was praying, the little boy became warm. His cheeks turned pink. He opened his eyes. He sneezed 7 times. When he saw his prophet friend, he smiled. Prophet Elisha sent for the boy's mother. "Take up your son," he said. "He is well." The woman of Shunem knelt before the prophet. "How can I thank you?" she asked. The prophet said, "It was God who made your boy well. Thank him. Take up your son and be happy." And she took him up. Now, her son was not only a prayed-for boy, he was also a made-well boy. That evening, we think we see the woman of Shunem sitting on the doorstep of her mud brick home, holding close her made well boy. The man of Shunem joins them and points to the room on the roof. We thought to do a kindness when we built the room, but the kindness has come back to us twice over. "Kindness always comes back," said the woman of Shunem. "Kindness comes back," whispered the sleepy little boy.